Welcome. Thank you for watching this video. In this video, I will explain you the private location security, which comes standard in Microsoft Dynamics 365 for finance and operations and human resources. For several security reasons, there should be a split between who can see which private details of persons in the system. One of the reasons would be, for example, the GDPR regulations from the European Union, where the private details of any European Union citizen is protected by European laws. Now, first I will explain you how you can determine which address in the system or any phone number is a private detail. I'll explain it using the employee form in the system. And as an example, I will take Ahmed. And Ahmed has two addresses in the system. There's a home address and there's the business address. In this demo environment, every home address is marked as being a private one. We can check this by clicking, for example, on the edit button, where there's an option where you can see this address is private. And when we look at the second address, the business address, this address is not marked as being a private address. Now we know how we can determine if an address or also even a phone number or an email address is a private one. We have to know which users can actually see the private addresses in the system or not. That's determined on the global address book parameters, where there's a tab page and setup for the private location security. On this form, we can select which roles will have access to the private details. If you look at the list with available roles, that will also list all your custom roles or even roles from an ISV solution. And for this demo purpose, I will remove the recruiter role, as I will now do a demo with a human resource assistant, which is Brooke, and also a recruiter, Jacob. Now, Brooke is able to see the private details as per setup, because the human resource assistant is one of the selected roles, and Jacob is not able to see the private details anymore. So first we'll start with a session where Brooke has her session already open. When Brooke goes to the employees, we'll take the same record with Ahmed. If you look at the addresses, we can indeed see that both addresses are available for Brooke. And also Brooke is able to click on edit and maintain if an address is a private address or not. Now the second user, Jacob, the recruiter in the system, when Jacob wants to open the employee form, to be consistent, we'll take the same Ahmed in the system. And we can see that only the business address is visible for Jacob. Now also, when you click on the edit button, there's no option for Jacob to mark an address as being private or not, because he has not the privilege to do so. But there's only one exception. When Jacob is looking at his own record, Jacob Robinson, he can see both the business and the home address. And when he clicks on the home address, the edit, you can also see that the private option is enabled. So any user who is restricted from being able to view private addresses or contact details can see his own record and maintain it and select which address or contact details is now private or not. So now we've seen the result of a user who actually can see the private addresses and the users who can't see the private details. If you want to set up the system using the private location security, you have to know that there are two prerequisites to be able to have it working correctly. The first one is a system administrator user is bypassing all security in the system. The private location security is built on the extensible data security framework in the system with security policies in a development environment. And also the system administrator is bypassing that security. So if you want to test the features or use it, ensure that the user has no system administrator role assigned, because otherwise he would be able to see all private details, regardless this setup. Now the second thing is the setup on the users. If we go to the system administrator users form, when we look, for example, at Jacob in the system, Jacob has a link to a person in the system. This means in this way, the system knows which person record, so which employee, is related to Jacob, so he can see his own records in the system. One last comment here is that if there's no person assigned to a certain user and the user does not have access to private location details, then if the person is not selected, in that case, he's still able to see the private addresses in the system. So ensure that a user does not have the system administrator role and a user is linked to a person in the system. So in this video, I've shown you all the details related to the private location security and also gave you some prerequisites to know when the private location security is actually working or not. Thank you for watching. Until next time. Bye bye.